I know I have done a lot of hurt, drama, and bullshit to your life, and I want to apologize. Really and sincerely, deep down, I really am, hun. I know you said you wanted me to cut ties with you. I'm sorry to bother you, okay? But I wanted to write you how I really feel and apologize for the shit I put you through. I know I was in the wrong majority and never gave you... gave you a chance to explain your part of your side. And I was so convinced by my family that you already moved on and didn't care about me at the time, and that I once went and started writing Shwanda after she wrote me first. Yes, I know I don't have my shit together right now, but here in the next 3.5 or 4.5 years, I'm going to work on myself and learn how to treat a woman right, and look back what I've done in the past and make sure I won't do it to the next woman. I'm realizing that not every woman isn't the same like the woman in the past I dated. I realize I fucked up our engagement, Emma. I realize that I failed God's test and that I will never get you back ever again. I'm not trying to manipulate you or play mind games with you. That's not what I'm doing in this letter. This is the Cody that you've seen, that's something that always was kept locked away from you, that you always tried to get out of me. But when you try to trust me, I always fucked it up. Emma, the reason for that is I was scared, and I honestly never had a good woman and beautiful as you. I never wanted to hurt you, but I guess that is a little bit too late for that. I was scared of trying not to fuck up. I always ending doing it. But it wasn't on purpose. I promise you that, yes, I will admit it. I was a self-centered individual that didn't care at the time. But I was slowly changing. Yeah, it wasn't as fast or the first thing that should have been done. I should have treated you more like the queen you deserve. And I should have made you feel like you were the only woman in this earth. And no woman would take your place. Make sure that was no doubt in your trust and loyalty, but I screwed that all to hell, and I'm suffering the consequences for all my actions and drama and bullshit that was put in your life. God and karma is punishing me every day. I really do think about you, Emma, and I truly do love you, but I realize I will never get your love back. I pressed you to your breaking point that you are done completely, and that is very understandable. A person like me that plays with a woman that's beautiful and is good to him doesn't deserve a woman like you. And that's what I'm trying to say here. I never put to thought how stressed you were when I got arrested in front of you, Emma. I do think about you every day. A deep depression so very quick, and I cry when I hear your name. I'm starting to realize slowly how I put you in a deep depression, or when I had you tasting so bad that you couldn't breathe. I honestly wish I could take everything back that you... Everything that I've done to you away. And maybe we couldn't be in this kind of situation, but life isn't like that. Look, I know you are a second choice, and I know you're not, and you shouldn't feel like that. You said... You said that I never loved you or cared about you. I hate to break it to you, Emma. You have changed my life, and I do love you and miss you like crazy. I have so many memories about us running in my head, and when I sleep at night, I don't know what you did to open my eyes and my heart, but I wanna... say thank you and sorry for all the hurt and torment that I caused. I realize now you have a limit, and I know the damage is done, and I won't ever get you back. Ever. All I do in here is think about stuff, but mostly I think about is what we had, and yes, I know I shouldn't have people coming between us. I'm trying not to cry while I'm writing this, but I will just hold on to it. I know that I was acting like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde and being two-faced by calling you then Shwanda. I do apologize, Emma, but know that I'm being 100 with you and telling you how I honestly feel. Shwanda Bedwell is going to get a letter from me saying that I'm breaking up with her and that I consider her more as a loving, caring friend than as a girlfriend. So if you are going to post this on Facebook, write her friends and talk about this on YouTube. I will have the both ends of Shwanda and you cut ties. And that way, there won't be no more damage dealt. I really do love you, Emma. Join me. I try to lay down and all I think about you. The craziest thing is people don't realize what they got good in front of them until it's stripped away from them. I like myself, Emma. I don't want anybody else, honestly and truthfully. I just want you, but like you said, I fucked up, and I'm going to deal with it the best way I can. But whoever you are with, either if it's with me or somebody else, I hope they make you happy, and I hope they are the ones you are looking for in life, sweetheart. I want you to be happy and smile, laugh, ECT, but if you could find it in your heart to forgive me, not right now, but here in the next 3-4 half years, and the reasons why I keep saying 3 to 4 years is because that's what I was sentenced to. They gave me a 1.5. On my probation, they gave me 3 years on the level 5 felony, and I have to serve one after the other. So by the time I get out, I will have longer hair. Find I will be looking way different, maybe a little bit more built. Who knows, but as soon as I get out, if you're okay, I would like to stop by and visit you for a little bit and get my stuff that I gave to you when I had it when I had got arrested on the 28th of January. But in all honesty, I don't want Shwanda, Holly, Kim, or Christina. When I get out, I won't be talking to a lot of people. It just seems that I cause people drama and bullshit in their lives. So, I'm going to make myself invisible for a long while after I'm out of prison. Emma, I hope you can see by this letter that I'm not making you pissed off, okay? If there's anything that I wouldn't do to have you back right now. I guess Shwanda was upset because I told her that couldn't I love her as much as I did you, and that my love will never change how I feel about you. She told me if I wanted you that I should go back to you, and she broke up with me, but I'm going to make it official that me and her are no longer together. The only person that I want back is you, Emma. It's really hard to move on, but your letter got to me really hard. That is striking like a lightning bolt, sticking more than one place. And it put me in a fetal position, curled up in a ball, crying and rocking back and forth. Emma, I know you're still...